I'm thinking about starting this new series where I can talk about new technologies and projects made using them, so I can spark some interest, all in under a given time limit. Not because it's challenging, but mostly because I'm lazy. So without further ado, welcome to Learn Bootstrap 4 in under 5 minutes. So what is Bootstrap? It's a CSS library that contains helpful classes and styles that we can reuse. It's used everywhere and very popular among most web developers. It's also an industry standard, so it's definitely worth learning. It's pretty simple too. You just need to visualize what goes where, use the right components, and you'll be done in minutes. So what do you need to know before starting off with Bootstrap? A little bit of HTML will go a long way, even the basics. CSS isn't a big necessity, but when you want to override a few styles, like change the color of a button, you might need it. Design thinking is a big plus. Not everyone can think creatively. Try and test the waters and see if it fits you. So what do you need to start working on Bootstrap? A simple intelligent code editor like Atom or VS Code should be more than enough. So what are we waiting for? Let's start the timer and begin. So let's start by creating a folder on our desktop. I'm gonna call mine Learn VS 4 under 5. Open up that folder in VS Code. Create a file called index.html in the folder and let's start writing some code. Just type HTML istify and then you'll get the boilerplate code for basic HTML. I'm gonna call this website Fake Company. Now, let's start to integrate Bootstrap. Go to your browser and type in getbootstrap.com. Once you're there, click on Get Started, and you can see how to quick start. So copy up the CSS link. Next, copy the JavaScript link. We're done. Now, let's add a navigation bar to our website. Go to getbootstrap.com. In the search, type navbar. Here, we can see basic examples of navbars. We want the most basic one, which can be found here. Copy paste that right here. Now, let's change the navbar heading to Fake Company. To view the website, open up the folder and double click on index.html and we can see the change. Now, let's create one of my most favorite components, a jumbotron. Let's create a container. Inside the container, let's create a jumbotron. Now, a h1 tag that has the company name. Next, a paragraph that says something about the company. Now, a hr tag so that we can create a horizontal rule and a paragraph with some fake text. Now, all we need is a simple button. In the button, let's say click here. Let's see how this looks on our website. The jumbotron looks good, but I think a few more styles need to be added. Let's first create the space on the top. We do that by adding the empty phi here. Empty phi means margin top phi. So we're basically adding a bit of margin on the top. Next, let's add the class display4 to h1. Next, a class lead to the paragraph. And to the button, all we need is a btn, btn primary, and btn-lg. Now our jumbotron looks amazing. Now, let's create three cards so that we can explain the features of the company. I'm going to create a container with empty phi, a row, and three columns. Within the first column, I'm going to create a card, and inside that card, a card body, a h3 tag with the card title, and a p tag with card text. Now, let's go to our website and check how it looks. Looking neat. Let's add three more cards. Now, when we refresh, we have three beautiful looking cards. Let's change the names of our features. And voila, our cards are ready. It's important to understand how the row and column system work. We can explain it using this. Basically, every page is divided into 12 columns, as we can see here. If we use a class, call-12, it takes up all 12 columns. If we use call-1 or any number, it basically uses that sized column. I'll put a link to this in the description below so that you can test it out. You can also view the source of this page so that you can see what all styles have been used. Believe it or not, that's all there is to learn about Bootstrap. Now, there are a few more classes which you can check out in the documentation of getbootstrap.com. Now, as an added bonus, let's also learn about Bootswatch. Go to bootstrapcdn.com and click on Bootswatch on the header. Here, we can see various themes that we can apply to our website. I like this. I'm gonna choose Cosmo. Copy this link, go to the HTML page, go to the top, and add the style sheet using link. Go to the website again, refresh, and now you can see the whole website has been themed with respect to the Cosmo theme. You can also add multiple themes. There's this theme called Sketchy, which I really love. Refresh, and it looks really comical. You can check out the other themes on the Bootswatch website. We got 1 minute 41 seconds on the clock. That means we still had some time to spare. Please do let me know how the video was in the comment section below, and please hit the like button if you really liked it. Also, if you have any suggestions for any upcoming videos, any technologies that you would want me to cover in under Y minutes, do let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe.